Hello, students. Mr. Allen here. We are going to look at section 3.2 today. We're actually going to kind of go back. And that's not a mistake. I did this on purpose. We're going to look at two theorems, Rolle's theorem and the mean value theorem. In fact, that's our only objectives today. Understand and use Rolle's theorem and understand and use the mean value theorem. Okay, Michael Rolle was a French mathematician, and he is given credit for this theorem, the Rolle's theorem, and it guarantees the existence of an extreme value in the interior of a closed interval. Here is his theorem. This is an important theorem. It's not the most important theorem of the two, but it is an important one, and I'll tell you why. This is called Rolle's theorem, and here's what it says. Let f be a continuous function on the closed interval ab and differentiable on the open interval a to b. So it needs to be continuous on the closed interval, differentiable on the open interval. And here's what it says. If f of a is equal to f of b, then there has to be at least one number c such that f prime of c is equal to zero. What this is saying, let me demonstrate to you, is if we have, let's say we have this function here, f, okay? And what I'd like you to notice is that this function, which looks like an upside down parabola. So here's where a is, here's where b is, and I'd like you to notice that f of a is equal to d, and f of b is also equal to d. So we've met the first criteria right here, that f of a equals f of b. I also should note that this function is continuous and differentiable on that interval, okay? Differentiable just means the derivative is defined there. If you want to think about it graphically, it just means that the curve is smooth. So what his function, what his theorem is guaranteeing us for this function is that if these three conditions are true, so 1, 2, 3, then we can conclude that there has to be some value c, and remember c is just an x value, where the derivative of that c is equal to zero. And remember, derivative equaling zero, so when f prime of c is equal to zero, we're essentially saying that the slope of the tangent line is zero, and that's exactly what we have right here, which is also what we call a relative maximum. We already know that from section 3.3. So Rolle's theorem tells us if the function's continuous and differentiable and f of a is equal to f of b, then there has to be some point in between there, c, where the derivative is equal to zero, the first derivative. Now, if the function is not continuous, or I'm sorry, if the function is not differentiable, in this case, the function is continuous, but it is not differentiable. And the reason it's not differentiable is right here. It turns out that f prime of c here is d and e. In other words, it is not differentiable. If a function is not differentiable, then you cannot apply Rolle's theorem. So let's look at an example of that. It says find the two x-intercepts of the function f of x. By the way, this first question, find the two x-intercepts. This is not calculus, this is an algebra 2 question. Actually, it's an algebra 1 question. And then the second part, this is the calculus part, is we want to show that, oops, sorry about that. That's not what I wanted to do. Actually, let's just get rid of all that ink. The calculus question is this part right here. We want to show that f prime of x equals zero somewhere in this interval. Okay, first note that this function, which by the way, I hope you guys all realize that this is just a parabola. It's a parabola, something we studied in algebra 1. So it is differentiable and continuous on the entire real number line, and it is also continuous and differentiable on this interval that we're going to find after we find the x, the two x values, which are the x-intercepts. That's what we're doing first, find the two x-intercepts. So to find the x-intercepts, we want to let y equal zero. In other words, we want x squared minus 3x plus 2 to equal zero. This would be something you would do in algebra 1. Then we can factor the polynomial. And then based on the factoring of the polynomial, we can clearly see that x equals 1 is one of the intercepts, and x equals 2 is one of the other intercepts. Thus, we can conclude that f of 1 is equal to 0 and f of 2 is equal to 0. This satisfies all three conditions of Rolle's theorem. In fact, let me review those three conditions. 1, the function has to be continuous on the closed interval. 2, it needs to be differentiable on the open interval. And 3, that f of a has to equal f of b. We have all of those things. So now we can use Rolle's theorem to show that there has to be at least one c on the interval where f prime of c is equal to 0. So now we need to figure out where that c value is. So we need to use the derivative. Now recall that our function here is f of x equals x squared minus 3x, I think it was plus 2. Is that right? Yep, there we go, plus 2. So what we're going to do is we're going to find the derivative. And what is the derivative of x squared minus 3x plus 2? Well, you guys can already use the power rule very simply. You know that that's going to be 2x minus 3. We want it to equal 0, so we're going to set this equal to 0. And then once we do that, we can quickly work that out. We're going to have 2x minus 3 equals 0. So 2x is equal to 3. X is equal to 3 halves. That's our c value. Let's look at this graphically. We showed in the first part that the x-intercepts were at 1 and positive 2. So those were our x-intercepts. Notice that in that case, we're saying that a is 1, b is 2. We also showed in the second step that c is 3 over 2. In other words, Rolle's theorem is validated by this example. Okay. All right, let's get to the mean value theorem. This is actually the most important theorem. In fact, if you know the mean value theorem, you actually get Rolle's theorem for free because Rolle's theorem is actually a subset of the mean value theorem. In fact, if you look at the criteria, it's very similar to the last one. The function has to be continuous on the closed interval. It has to be differentiable on the open interval. Then there exists a number c such that f prime of c is equal to f of b minus f of a over b minus a. Now, I cannot overstate the importance of this theorem. In fact, some people say that this is actually one of the fundamental theorems of calculus. Here's what this theorem is essentially saying. I'm going to explain what I just put here in this box two different ways. This is saying, as long as the function's continuous and differentiable, that there is some value for C where the instantaneous rate of change is equal to the average rate of change. Remember, on the left-hand side, the derivative, F prime of C, that's the instantaneous rate of change. The right-hand side, that's the average rate of change. Those are formulas we've already looked at. So the mean value theorem tells us that there has to be some point C where those two things are equal. Another way to think about it is this. The left-hand side of the equation is telling us that the slope of the tangent line is some value, and it tells us that the slope of the secant line also has that same value for some value c. Let's look at an example of the mean value theorem, and I would encourage you, if what I've just tried to describe doesn't quite make sense, I would encourage you to watch this video again or watch some other videos available on YouTube, because this is a really important theorem, and it will make sense, and I'll do my best to explain it to you in this video and in class. So example 2, it says finding a tangent line. It says given f of x equals 5 minus 4 over x, and I didn't really write that in there well, but this is the same thing as 4 over x. Find all values c on the open interval such that 1, on the open interval 1, 4, such that f prime of c is equal to f of 4 minus f of 1 over 4 minus 1. Okay. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to figure out what the slope of the secant line is. To find the slope of the secant line, that's the right-hand side here. So we need to figure out what f of 4 is. Well, just to make sure you understand what f of 4 means, f of 4 means that we're going to put 4 into our function here. So this is 4 over, and then in this case, I said, what's f of 4? I should have done this in purple. Okay. So what is 5 minus 4 over 4? Well, 4 over 4 is 1, so 5 minus 1 is, coincidentally, it's 4. F of 1 turns out to be 1. The denominator is 4 minus 1, so clearly this is equal to 1. The slope of the secant line, the slope of the secant line, and I should put the word slope, is 1. Okay, great. We also need to make sure that we remember that there are two conditions that have to be met for the mean value theorem to apply. The function has to be continuous on the closed interval, and it has to be differentiable on the open interval, and that is the case here, and I'll show you that in a minute when I show you the graph, but just trust me that both of these conditions are true. All right, so now we want to try to find those C values. So that is, if f of x is continuous on the open, okay, that's what I just said. So there has to be some value C, and it could be more than one, where f prime of C is equal to 1. So now we need to find f prime of 1. Now I'm going to go ahead and skip past this piece, but remember that f of x, on the previous slide there, f of x is 5 minus 4 over x. So I'm going to leave it to you to verify that the derivative of f of x is 4 over x squared. We need to figure out when that's equal to 1, so that's why we've set it equal to 1. Now I'm going to show the work here just to verify that it is indeed plus or minus 2. So what we would do is here is we would cross multiply, so you get 4 equals x squared times 1, which is just 4 equals x squared. And of course, hopefully you can clearly see why that's plus or minus 2. So these are going to be the potential C values. And we got to be careful here because we're only interested in C values between 1 and 4. So one of them is not going to work. We don't need that negative 2 value. So now let's look at the graph of this function. So this black graph here is the function 5 minus 4 over x. And it turned out that f of 1 was 1 and f of 4 was 4, just coincidentally. So that means the slope of the secant line, which I'll do in purple, that's this point, this line right here, this is the secant line, has to be equal to the slope of the tangent line, which is up here in blue, for some value of C. And remember, the two C values we got, which is plus or minus 2, well, it turns out that when X is equal to 2, because remember, negative 2 is not between 1 and 4, we're interested in 1 and 4, this produces the tangent line slope of 1 as well. So what I'm saying is f prime of 2, which is going to be, remember, f prime was 4 over x squared. When you plug 2 into this, you get 4 over 4, which is indeed 1. Again, verifying the mean value theorem. That's it, guys. Thanks for your attention.